friend Jace.
Hello.
For those of you who saw my video on the elephant made of stones, that was for him. So he's here today, and we're going to make something. I don't know what. We have, what is the idea? We're going to sketch on a piece of paper each, but like we're going to tell the other person what to draw, and they can't, and they're not going to be able to see the image or know what it is until after. We're just going to tell them, draw this.
It's basically, so an example would be like, I tell her to draw a Pegasus and give her like different details. I can look at the pictures, but she can't.
Exactly. So, for those of you that also don't know, I will be putting Jace's Twitter. Do you want you to put your Twitter in?
Yeah, I haven't touched it in forever, but yeah.
He makes art, too. He's a great artist, which I'm sure you'll notice in this video.
I do mainly JoJo's Bizarre Adventure art, so if you're into that, I don't know, just the link to my Twitter will probably be in the description.
Yeah, it'll be in the description below so you guys can see that. All right, so I think that's good. You want to start going?
Sure.
All right, let's do this.
Woo!
Okay, so we've segmented Jace's paper into three sections.
Easy, medium, hard.
And what we're going to do is we're each going to get our own piece of paper, and we're going to swap off through each round. And Jace is the first one to go and start drawing, and I'm going to tell Jace what to do. Jace, you're going to be drawing your character Echo. For those of you who don't know, that's one of his own original characters. For the easy round, we're drawing our own characters, that the other has chosen and knows of. All right, you ready to go?
Sure.
Okay, the first thing I want you to draw Echo doing is sort of like, make a little pole. Make a pole. This is what he's a pole or some big, tall, like, pillar. And that's just to sort of get an idea.
Pillar man for all my JoJo fans out there. Okay, it's not straight. Whatever. I don't care. I'm not straight either.
And then the next thing you're going to do is have, so Echo's going to be putting his hands stretching his hands out towards the pole. He's going to be facing the pole, the pillar pole thing, and like looking at you while putting his butt out towards
okay,
you.
Hold on, I'm gonna move the pole to the other side.
You didn't think I was gonna go this route, did you?
No, I immediately knew, like, when you said put his hands up there, I was like, oh no.
So yeah, that's what you gotta start doing, is drawing him like that. Okay. Hands on the pole, so you see the back and the butt out. One leg is also up against the pole, the right leg, and the back leg is sticking out, and the head is turned towards, is facing you.
Okay. Like fully, or like a three-quarters turn?
Three-quarters.
Okay. For those of you who don't know, Echo is my tiefling character in a D&D campaign that her husband is running. And he's, let's just say he's a little, flamboyant.
Yeah. So, Jace, while you're doing this, what exactly is, Echo? You said that he's a character, but what is he?
I said he's a tiefling.
Oh, you did say he's a tiefling.
I did say
he's... I'm deaf!
Yeah. I said he was my tiefling character D&D.
Isn't he pink?
Yeah, he has, like, a light pink skin.
Oh my gosh.
His hair is
long. You're going
to
break that lid so bad.
No, the point of it is so I draw, like, lighter.
You draw differently than I do, so...
Yeah, I think I've noticed that.
But that's okay, everyone has their own drawing style.
But he's got a very light pink skin. It's kind of a gradient, so like it gets darker the farther down you go on his body. He has goat feet, and his horns, they kind of curl up like a... What are those things called?
Ram?
No, rams are spiral. Their horns are spiral.
Oh, they curl up. So, antelope?
No. I don't know.
I don't know either.
just like kind of a normal demon horn, I guess.
Okay.
But he's got long black hair. He has heterochromia. His eyes are two different colors. I forgot he doesn't actually have pupils, and I just drew those, so...
I gave you erasers for a reason.
I am not using those big-ass erasers. Oh. Horns, yeah, they're like long, kind of normal demon horns. They're just longer. One of them's actually broken, so... Are you laughing at me?
Yes, and wasn't it like he's got a... He's so traumatized, he's gotta have that broken horn, right? Is it trauma, or what? How did he get the broken horn?
His horn actually broke when his mother gave birth to him.
Oh, okay.
So, the kind of headcanon thing for him is that he actually had horns when he was born.
Okay.
But they were, like, just really small, and it didn't have, like, that was much more blunt, I guess, is the easy way to put it.
Oh, also, side note, because that's a great story, Jace, but side note, sorry about the bad lighting. It's nighttime now. Even though it's, like, what is it, like, 5:45, it's dark as can be.
Perks of living in the north.
Yeah. The far north.
Yeah, we're like, 2 hours from Canada right now?
Yeah. Something like that. And also, I have really bad lighting in my apartment. Like, seriously, this room does not have any overhead lighting. I think I've mentioned this before. I'm stuck to just lamps. And also, because it's going to be the two of us, we're drawing on the floor and not on my desk. So.
Yeah.
Hopefully, eventually, I'll get a better setup. It's bad.
His arms are too thick.
You're doing it, though.
His arms are too thick.
Them are chubby arms.
I'm trying, okay? Okay. So, you said his right leg?
His right leg
is against the pole.
Yeah. His foot is against the pole, technically. So his leg is going out there, but his foot up to his knee line up with the pole.
Okay.
And his foot is at a side view.
Okay. It took me a second to realize what that meant. What should he be wearing for clothes?
I will tell you clothing after you've drawn pose.
Oh, okay, I guess.
That's how I do things.
I guess that works.
No clothes and then... no clothes with pose and then you add the clothes.
This is family friendly, I promise. Is his left leg, is it like supposed to be like out like this?
Yes, okay. Exactly like that.
Okay.
You do not see his toes on that one. You just see his ankle.
What?
You only see the back of his ankle. You don't see his toes. His toes are pointing away from you.
That sounds painful.
He's almost going spread eagle.
God. Are you trying to kill my son?
Yes. Remember, I don't like him.
Oh yeah, your character fucking hates him.
Yeah. Oh man, I'm gonna have to bleep that with the dog.
You're already gonna have to bleep a lot. I've already sworn a lot.
I guess Unicorn Duck's gonna make her appearance.
Yeah. Bro, this looks painful for him.
I'm sure he can handle it.
He doesn't even have toes anyway. It's just a fucking heel.
Oh, man.
He looks like he's having a great time. Does it have to be pressing against the pole or just parallel to it?
It's parallel to the
parallel.
Pole.
Okay.
But it's like covering up the front of the pole.
Is this pole supposed to be diagonal?
I told you this is a pillar. This is a pillar, but I keep saying pole.
Is the pillar?
The pillar is vertical. It's upright.
Yeah, nobody's legs are that fucking long.
I can't wait to show you the picture.
Oh, I'm scared.
It's the angle of which she's standing. Because I'm using a woman for this pose.
Well, I mean, he looks like a woman anyway.
Exactly. So. And it's at the... And also, posing has no gender.
That is very true.
You can take a man and turn them into a woman if you really want to.
Hey, you know what? All my JoJo fans out there, like, comment, and subscribe. if you like seeing big, dynamic JoJo men. Oh my god, that foot looks so painful.
It does!
I'm sorry, baby. I'll make it up to you, I promise.
Oh, man.
Yeah, you didn't...
I'm almost tempted to just have you use the clothing on this chick, too. Because, oh man, I just feel like it'd be great. I think I'm going to. She has, like, little to no clothes, but, I mean...
Alright, well, there's the pose, so...
Okay, so now, put a wrap around the head, the top of the head.
A wrap.
A wrap on the head, so it comes up, like, not a turban, but,
A hijab?
A hijab. Oh, not necessarily a hijab, but, you know, like, you know how it covers your whole head? But it's kind of like, you know, when you wrap your head up in... But yeah, kind of like a hijab, I guess. And then, but then it comes down, it curls down, and it has a big, it goes around the breast area, so the chest, and then covers the butt, and then goes in, and then flows down onto the ground between the legs.
That's the only piece of clothing there is?
Oh my god!
I know I said nothing sexual, but...
Hey, as long as nothing's showing, it's
exactly.
Good for
YouTube. Exactly. I know I said I wanted to be clean, but I changed my mind.
Okay, well, I'm not going to draw it like an actual hijab because they...
You can take creative liberty.
Yeah.
And do whatever you want with it. This is just what I'm saying.
Well, there's going to be, like, holes in the headscarf thing.
That's
so
fine.
So these horns can come through. And then it curls around.
Yeah, it goes over underneath the right arm. So underneath the right arm, and then to cover the chest.
Okay, so it comes around this way.
And then it goes, but no, that's not the right way.
No?
No, the other way. It just goes under the right arm, and then it curves towards the left. It turns towards the left, going covering the chest. Yes.
Okay.
And then it comes back around the body from the left, going down towards the right to cover the booty.
Okay. Is it like?
And yeah, that comes from behind though. That comes from behind, from the back.
Yeah. That's
and then it goes underneath the right leg, and just starts flowing onto the ground, in between the legs.
So, just like this. This is like one giant...
No, it goes under the right leg.
Under the right leg.
The right leg's supposed to be the one parallel with the foot parallel. I just realized you got the legs messed up.
No, that's his right leg.
Well, I'm looking at this picture from behind. The right leg from when you... Say you were the person doing this. The right leg... That was supposed to be the left... Oh, well, I guess you flipped it around. So, I guess the left leg.
No, you said right leg.
Yeah, I'm saying you flipped the image. I realize now, because I'm looking at this from upside down, that it's flipped... That you did it flipped. Like...
That's your own damn fault.
It is.
That's not on me. That's your own
damn
fault.
Yeah, it is my own fault.
Okay, it goes under the right leg?
It goes under the leg. Now you just have to go over the right leg. Creative liberties, people. Liberties.
Gonna, like,
because we got the angles of the
I'm going to do it like this.
Yeah, that's basically... It's got to go. It'll work. It's not going to be... It's not meant to be exactly like this picture anyways. We're just using the posing and the clothing. I mean, it's not horribly off.
Okay, give him some texture. He's gonna have a nipple showing because that's not illegal on
no,
YouTube.
No, he's a dude. It's illegal on Tumblr. Which is ridiculous. I still find that ridiculous. Free the titties, please.
He's done.
Are you done?
Yeah, I guess.
Okay.
Wait, let me just...
I knew that was gonna happen.
Shut up.
Ready? To see what it was?
Oh, I forgot his tail!
Oh, yeah!
I was like, I already know I'm gonna draw his tail, and I forgot his freaking tail!
Okay. Oh, man, this is awesome.
Well, it's a good thing his tail has, like, a mind of its own.
This is great.
Very, very long.
I don't even know who I'm gonna have to draw.
Oh, I already know who I'm gonna tell you.
You're gonna draw. You know who I'm gonna have to draw?
Yeah.
I hope it's someone I've been drawing recently, because I might forget some things.
Uh-oh, Spaghetti-O. And I'm giving him a spades tail, because you know what? I go by spades online, so... That's what people
Man, I almost want to just keep drawing the same characters, but in even vastly harder poses.
No, we're not doing that. We already decided.
I know.
Okay, now I'm done.
I love his tail. He's gorgeous.
He looks like a god.
He does! I feel like that should be his normal clothing in-game. Am I wrong?
Knowing your character, knowing Esmeralda, she would just rip it off to try to embarrass him.
No, she's not that mean. At the very least, she'd be like, cover yourself. And it's like, or get out of my way, Pinky.
Smash her with that.
Get out of my way, Pinky.
Alright, well, there he is.
Alright, well, I guess it's my turn now, so I gotta get over on the other side. Let's switch!
Alright, so now it is Amber's turn to work on her easy drawing. She's going to be drawing her character Angel, who is personally my favorite of her characters.
A question for you. Am I going to draw Angel as a mermaid in her true form or in her human form?
Human form.
Okay. For those of you that don't know, I have a comic called Lost Memories, and if you don't know, I'm surprised, especially if you've been watching my videos. I've made a couple already, which I will link down below, so you guys can check them out, along with my comic. granted, Angel has not appeared yet. I hope to have her in sometime in the future. No idea when she'll appear, but...
Spoiler warning.
Yeah. But if you've ever followed me on any of my other social media throughout the years, I have drawn her numerous times, and I love her. She's one of my adorable mermaid girls.
Yeah, she's my favorite. So, in her human form,
okay,
it's going to be a frog pose. So, her body is going to be facing towards you.
Okay.
Her... right hand is going to be like this.
Oh, I think I know what picture this is.
No, shut up. So, yeah, the hands are going to be like this. So, right one forward, uh-huh. Left one back.
Okay.
And she's going to be facing towards the right.
Okay.
With, like, a three-quarters view. Okay. And she's going to be looking off that way, too.
Okay.
And with her legs,
I'm going to have to ask a lot of questions again.
The right one is farther out. So, you'll see her hip. And then you'll see the leg.
Okay.
It's pointed towards this way. You can see the toes for both for both feet. The right foot is kind of angled this way a little bit.
Okay.
So kind of angled to the right, and the left foot is angled to the left.
Okay.
So get started.
Let me just hit the play and the music again.
For those of you that don't know, I use a lot of my husband's music sometimes. And this is his CD, so we have it playing in the background so we don't feel like it's quiet and we have nothing to listen to.
And also, we don't want to get copyright striked by YouTube.
Yeah. The only other music I do use is stuff that's already on my system that is copyright free because I use the Corel, so. All right, so frog pose. That's what I gathered of this, frog pose.
Yeah.
Okay.
Also, for those of you who don't know, I have my obsession with elephants, but I am also very obsessed with frogs. Frogs, yeah. And toads and elephants.
Okay,
like my
so
favorite.
Remind me, where are the arms on?
So, right hand is out.
Okay.
And it's only the fingertips touching the floor. So
okay.
Not the palm.
So I'm just gonna do this, because this is the best way I can think of to do frog pose. I have to do stick figures, especially for really difficult ones, so like this?
Yep.
Okay, and then it's the hands outward, like?
Yeah, they're like this.
Okay. Oh man, this is hard. Granted, I could never, I normally would not probably draw Angel like this. This is something I'd probably reserve for, like, I don't know, my character Selma or something. But,
well, I mean, too bad! I like frogs!
Okay, so what's her left hand doing?
So the left hand is behind the right hand, and only three of the fingers are on the floor.
Okay.
And with the legs, they're more straight out rather than upward.
Okay. That helps a little bit.
Sorry.
You're fine. I tormented you, so now you get to torment me. Is it, like, is the left hand on the right side or the left side of the right hand?
It's on the right side.
Okay. Just so I can get an idea. I know this sounds weird.
Yeah. And you'll actually see the left foot in between both of the hands. Like, it's behind, but it's between them.
What the hell?
Just to kind of give you, it's going to be like this.
I do know this pose.
No, you don't! Shut up!
I use a lot of references for myself.
Yeah, okay. You didn't have this one saved, so I doubt.
Well, I haven't used it, because it's so complicated. Okay, so it's, like, they're, like, parallel, are they, like, horizontal, the top of the legs are horizontal to the ground?
The right one is more horizontal.
Okay.
The left one is slightly at an upward angle.
Okay. Alright.
Yeah.
Okay. Gotta get all this, the skeletals. Okay, and then the is the right leg going to be in between, or is it the left leg?
The left leg is
in okay, between. So where's the right leg go?
So the right leg is just to the right of the left hand.
Okay, so it goes inward, and then the foot is right next to the right of the hand?
Yeah. Okay. And it's, like this. So, balls of the feet to the ground, no sole on the ground.
Toes pointing towards me or yes. To the side? Okay.
Pointing towards you.
So balls to the feet, you said?
Yep.
Balls to the feet. I'm sorry, all I can think of is balls to the wall.
That's not what I was thinking of, but...
I honestly don't know the lyrics.
I was thinking of Get Low.
Oh, I do so like that song.
Drop down my balls.
Oh my god. Oh man, I'm never gonna. No, that's. You know, and I just had the lyrics that are asked to use my video. To, like, share my videos, and now I'm scared to post this. Also, shout out to the Lyric Center for that. They're awesome. Okay. And then this one's going in between?
Yep, in between the two hands.
Okay, like that. And is it pointing left or right? Or forward or to the
It's angled to the left.
To the left, okay.
Angled forward to the left.
Okay. This is a mess.
I believe in you, man.
I don't! So it's good to know someone believes in me. This hand is terrible.
Your face is terrible.
I know. I hate this hand!
I heard it was just a yee.
Okay, so, oh man, that is probably one of the worst hands ever, because I can't draw hands without references.
Hey, new artists out there, hands are one of the things you should start practicing first.
Yeah, you want to be able to be a god at them.
Hands and facial expressions.
Yes.
I've been doing this since 2008.
And I've been doing this since 2011. So, and I still can't draw anything very well. my art deceives, I'll just say that. So, as I keep trying to say, but keep getting interrupted because of my husband, as much as I love him, he's annoying. I know, I have no chill. Angel is a mermaid. I don't want to give too much out about her because she hasn't shown up yet, but she is the youngest of four, well, technically five, but she is the youngest sister of my mermaids. Of a couple of my mermaid girls. She is the happy-go-lucky one. And she is, like, technically she's based off of an angel shark, which is why her name is Angel. I'm real original, aren't I? But yeah, I mean, there's not much else to say about her. She still has a lot of ways to go before I can totally have her whole thing down, but she's a very happy, optimistic character. Leg is weird. Is the calf, like, this part here is very weird. Is that, like, is, which is more in front, the calf or the thigh?
So the leg actually looks like this.
Oh, so they're parallel to each other. Okay.
Well, just, yeah.
That's what I'm trying, yeah. No, I know. I know it's never going to be truly parallel, but it helps.
Yeah.
It helps to know, because
it's the same for the left leg. They're parallel.
Okay.
Yeah, because the left leg is like this.
Okay.
The heel is slightly off the ground.
Okay. On the left, I think, leg. I've got that then.
Okay.
Okay. I think I've got it. I think I can manage this. Maybe.
Also, her hair is going to be in braided pigtails.
Okay.
So, like, the Helga braids.
Definitely different from what I would normally do with her.
Yeah,
Helga braids. Because she has the big, huge, wavy hair, and oh man, that leg is huge. Proportions are terrible. I'm not going to even bother.
Yeah, it looks fine.
I just wanted to at least get something right here.
She really do be looking like a frog on camera, though.
Oh, man. Okay, so I got to get her little face.
Three-quarter view.
Oh, three-quarter view?
Yeah.
Okay. I wish I would have known.
I did tell you.
I didn't listen.
Well, that's your own damn fault.
Looking towards the right, okay.
Looking towards the right.
Up or down? Or just totally straight right?
Slightly down.
Okay. We'll see if that happens.
Did I give you that bracelet?
I don't know. You might have. I have a lot of bracelets.
I was like, I don't remember you ever talking about Attack on Titan.
I like Attack on Titan sometimes. I just don't watch. Oh god, that face is horrendous. I liked her better looking straight.
Well, sorry, that's not how the pose is.
Boo.
Hey, I used to actually, like, full-on practice dynamic poses, so.
I still practice them all the time just because I want to be better. And, oh man, I can't get this head! It's killing me. This head is killing me.
You can do it.
No, I'm gonna fail.
You can do it.
No, I can't! Okay, so I do know what pose you went with. I really do. She's got weird little ears.
I thought you were talking about the pose. I was like, huh?
No, not the pose. I'm talking about Angel. She's got weird little ears.
Got them elf ears.
Not necessarily. They kind of have, like, pointed ends.
That's kind of hard to see from here.
It is very hard to see, but they have little pointed ends. I don't know if you want to zoom in on them or not, but that's okay.
No.
And that's just how I like them to have, because when they're mermaids, they have more like a fin-like texture to their ears. But then when they're humans, it kind of fuses. Oh, she's not looking right. Oh, well, it's the closest I'm going to get. I'm just going to have her smile. She's going to have a big smile because she's a smiley, smiley character. Unless I have to do something else with her.
No.
Okay.
The girl's kind of smiling, so.
Okay. There. She's going to have just a big, big old smile on her face. Man, I hate this drawing of her already. Why did you draw so much better than me?
I don't know. Because you explained the thing so much easier, probably.
Learn to explain better.
Shut up. I'm trying my hardest. Okay.
Oh, and by the way, she's another pink character.
Oh yeah, she does have pink skin.
These mermaids are very pink. The sisters are very pink. Okay, and then you said what? Her hair's doing what now?
Helga braids.
What's a Helga braids?
Yeah. So it's like the braids that come down like this.
Okay.
Yeah, those are Helga braids.
I've never heard that term before.
You've never watched Hey Arnold?
I have watched Hey Arnold, but doesn't mean I've actually known that term. Also, I never really was that into Hey Arnold, so.
Exactly. My point is exactly.
See, this is more of the braiding style that I would give to, what's her name? Leela. Leela has more of this braided style.
To be honest, Angel was the only name I remembered. And also, she's my favorite, so.
Well, Angel is adorable.
That works out anyway. Do you remember when I drew her?
I do! You did such a great job with her.
I kind of want to redraw it, but I don't know if I still have it.
I have, like, so many drawings of her. It's crazy. I have this one that I love to just keep doing it over and over, because I am very original with my art.
Well, it's no, also I'm good not. To see how well you've progressed.
That is true.
That's what I do with one of my old, really old Hitalia drawings. Like, oh, in 2014.
Yeah. Shout out to Hitalia fans. I still love it. Cannot wait till 2021 when they bring out the new season. I only found out about that recently, so I'm so excited. And I'm totally pre-ordering that. I just love Hitalia. It helped me get through school. And they have very, very curly hair. She's so cute. That's, what else? What's her clothing?
Alright, so, she's got black shorts on.
Okay.
They are booty shorts.
Booty shorts, okay. Mm-hmm. I'm gonna take a little creative liberty and give her kind of torn up.
That's fine.
Just because I, when I think of her, because she is based on Angel Shark, oh, I forgot her fang. She has little fangs. She's an angel shark!
Yeah!
She's gotta have things little torn up! Okay.
Okay, and then she's wearing a green muscle top, so it's like a really thick tank top.
Okay.
I don't know why I'm giving you the colors. It's not like you're gonna color it.
No, I don't think there'll be enough time to color it, unfortunately. maybe another day we'll do a couple colored illustrations. Or at least one each.
And then she'll have bandages on both wrists.
Okay.
And both ankles.
Going over the hands?
They stop right at the knuckles.
Okay. Like that?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And then over, does she have shoes on or no?
No.
Okay, so it goes on her.
With the bandages on the ankles,
mm-hmm.
The heel is showing and the toes are showing.
Her feet are going to probably end up looking more like paws, unfortunately. Okay, so. Yeah, this is more of a pose that I would deem necessary for Leela.
Which, too bad.
I know. Just because it's more of a cat-like pose, in my opinion. And
a frog.
Well, to me, it looks like cats. Okay, is
I
that it?
I don't know what kind of cats you're looking at. But yeah, that's it.
Okay. I want to just do this because I like doing this. And I'll darken those shorts up just to make it look a little different. And she has very pale skin, and her hair is just slightly.
I didn't go that much.
I can't help myself! There, okay, she's fine.
Alright, 3, 2, 1.
Okay, guys, now we're gonna do the medium one. Again, Jace is gonna be drawing this one. And for the medium, it's kind of gonna be a toss up. This could be both hard or easy. We're not really going to say what it is. I will say we're both going to have to draw an animal for this one, but we're not going to tell each other what the animal is. We're just going to describe it and kind of what it's doing, which could make this extremely easy or very hard at the same time.
I guarantee you she picked out a dog or a cat, even though I told her not to.
I didn't. Okay, you ready to do it, Jace?
Sure.
Okay.
Is it a nope rope?
Huh? A what?
A nope rope?
I don't know what that is.
Snake.
Oh, a snake! Okay. I thought that was a spaghetti.
No.
I thought they were a spaghetti, an unedible spaghetti.
No, they're nope ropes.
I don't know. Okay. No, it's not that. Okay, so it is very floofy. It's small, it's a little baby. It's got a triangular body. Get the triangular body going with the tiny little head on top and little triangle feet.
Did you give me a duck?
I was like,
wait a second. All right, so she gave me her favorite animal, which is a duck.
Well, it's one of my favorites, but probably definitely a top favorite for me. But it's walking towards you.
Oh, fuck.
That's why it's got a triangular body and a little oval head on top.
And this is a baby?
This is a baby duckling. And it's walking. So one foot, one of its feet is coming up off the ground, and it's not even triangular. It's just sort of flat.
One of them is on the ground?
One is on the ground. That's triangular. Its little feet are walking towards you.
Okay. Let me tell you guys, I am not good at drawing animals. This already looks like the character from Rocko's Modern Life. Shout out to all the old Disney fans. Disney. Nickelodeon, I mean. I know what I'm talking about.
No, you don't.
Shut up. Oh my god, how do I draw a duck?
Like I said, triangular body, round oval head, with little triangle feet. That's at least how I'd start out.
No, I'm drawing a cute little
you
duck
You start
face.
Out with its little face. I love that bill.
I don't know, it's just a fucking duck.
It's adorable.
It's a duck.
It's adorable.
It's a duck.
It's adorables.
Are its wings out at all?
No, you can't even see its wings.
Okay, so it's just...
It's just a floofy triangle. It's a very floofy triangle body.
Is it quacking?
No, its mouth is closed. Okay. Its bill is actually at a downward angle.
Well, I changed that, though.
I like that face. That face is like, I hate you. That face is like, don't look at me.
So, which...
It's, right foot.
Is on
right
the ground.
Foot is on above, but yeah, the one you're drawing right now is on the ground. When I say right, I mean like right when it's like if you were in the duck's position. That's how I mean when I'm saying sides. So that one is like triangle with the ground. The other one is up and moving towards you. Does that make sense?
No.
But it's not covering the body.
God damn it! I hate this drawing.
I think it's adorable.
I hate drawing.
I love this duck. It's so cute. I want you to make this digital for me.
No.
I want a sticker of it.
No.
Yes. It's definitely like not the exact same thing, but it's so cute.
That's it. I'm done.
Do you want to see the duck?
Oh my god! Oh.
I love your duck! I want a sticker of that!
Oh my god. Well, way back again, and it is Amber's turn. She gave me her favorite animal, so I'm giving her mine.
Oh no. No! I had such a hard time with the stone elephant!
That's what you get!
I hate you!
So. Oh, well, I guess I wasn't supposed to tell you what it was, but.
No, whatever. But it doesn't. I mean, all you had to say was favorite, and I know what your favorite animal is, so.
Actually, no, you don't.
Really?
Yeah, you don't actually
it's
know.
It's not an elephant? What is it?
My favorite animal is an alligator.
Alligators are cool.
Yeah.
I have some fun
you're drawing an elephant.
Okay, I knew it.
Okay, so.
How am I going to fit an elephant on here?
Good luck. So first of all, you want to draw a little stone, like to the right.
Okay.
Like, going off the page.
Okay.
Like that? That'll work, I guess.
If the elephant goes over to the next one, I don't care. I'll just erase the border.
Alright, so, you cannot see all of this elephant. You can see its face. It's looking to the right.
Okay.
And its trunk is going to the right.
Okay. Question for you. How high above the stone is it? The head.
Not very.
Like, is it another stone length high, or is it small?
No.
Is this a baby elephant?
This is a baby
okay.
elephant.
Okay. That helps.
You gave me a baby duck, I give you a baby elephant.
Okay, so a little elephant. Wait, is the trunk hanging or up?
It's hanging.
It's hanging, okay. So, here's my elephant head. And here's... No, don't do that to me.
You have lead.
I got plenty of lead. Well, it's gonna cross over. I'll move the stone.
Yeah, move it down, like, way farther.
I'll move the stone.
Move it down off the page.
I'll move it So there's the trunk. There's the trunk. Is it curling at all?
Slightly.
Up?
No.
Down?
It's curling to the right.
It's curling under?
No.
Oh, to the right? So is it curling up?
It's just going like this.
Okay. That's what I meant. Get that tube.
Well, the elephant's face is facing toward you.
It, what?
I told you that.
I obviously, again, do not listen. I have a listening issue. It's called I Don't Care.
How do you expect to do a fucking collaboration with people if you don't listen?
Because I do listen, but you're not important.
Gay man, your wife is bullying me. No!
I hate you.
I love you too. Oh man. Is that right? I think that right. I don't know. Oh man.
Yeah, close enough.
So you said we got a stone here?
Farther down.
Farther down?
Yes.
How low is
this? I said going off the page.
I thought you meant towards the right.
No!
There. That better?
Yes.
Okay. Alright, now what?
The ears are out.
Okay.
And the tops are slightly curved downwards.
I might have learned.
You know, you could have just stopped at the line.
No. No.
That means less draw. Less draw.
No, no. Okay, and the little eyes, are they open?
Yes.
I'm going to give them anime eyes. And since it's a baby, give it little eyelashes, because I can. There. It looks so cute.
The left leg is stepping onto the stone.
Okay.
And you can see the slight bottom of the foot.
I feel like that stone needs to be bigger.
Yeah, it needs to take up at least half of that section.
There. I think that seems more proportionally right.
So yeah, the left leg is coming onto the stone, and you can see the underside of the foot.
Okay. I learned an interesting thing about elephants recently. And that is that they actually, the females, they have a 2-year gestation period. Takes them 2 years to have babies! Mm-hmm. Which is crazy.
Another interesting fact about elephants, they don't have heels.
Yeah, they got cankles.
No.
I know, I'm joking.
Their heels are, it's literally just fat.
No, yeah, I know. It's basically, which is why I said cankles.
Also, those aren't toes, those are knuckles.
Oh, right. I didn't know that.
Yeah.
There's so many interesting things about animals, it's crazy. You didn't tell me anymore, so I went with what I would imagine this elephant's foot is doing.
So, the right foot is off of it's behind the stone.
It's behind the stone,
behind
okay.
The stone. And you can see its butt, barely.
Its butt?
Yeah, and it's going behind, no.
No?
No.
No?
Elephants don't bend like that.
I don't know.
It's literally from the ear, it's just going, watch my hand, it's just going like this.
What? Like this?
No.
No? What?
From the ear, the middle of the ear where you drew that.
Okay.
It's just going, yeah, curving like that and then going straight down.
Straight down, okay.
And there you go, there's your elephant. Do you want to see the picture?
Yeah. I'm very confused. Aww, it's so cute. It's much better than this mess. All right, now it's time for the last final round, round 3. For this one, we decided we're going to go with I can't speak.
Mythological creatures.
That word. But yeah, we're going to do mythological creatures, and the rule is, I do not say what it is, I do not give a pose, Jace can do whatever he wants for a pose, just like when it's my turn, I can do whatever I want, But I have to describe what this creature is without saying what it is. And Jace has to kind of figure it out on his own.
Yeah.
Okay. And it can be a very simple mythological creature or a very complicated one.
I swear to God, if I get a fucking manticore.
No, it's not a manticore. Okay, you ready to go?
Yeah.
Okay. So, another thing is we did decide, what, the origin? Or
yeah,
origin?
So like if okay. it's Greek or like Roman mythology, stuff
okay.
like that.
Okay, well, speaking of origins, I'm going to tell you right now, this is something that is technically, it's, I think it might technically be both Greek and Egyptian, because it appears in both mythologies, if I'm correct. Do not quote me, but if I'm correct, it can appear in both.
Okay.
I know for certain it is in Greek. So, and anytime you get a guess, let me know.
Is it a harpy?
No. So, it has the head of a human. Okay. A human head. It has wings. It has a tail.
Wow.
It has actually, okay, so head of a human. It has wings. And its entire body is a cat.
Oh, it's a sphinx.
Yes! So that's what you have to draw as a sphinx.
Okay.
If I'm correct, usually the sphinx is also female.
The sphinx isn't Greek? I thought it was just Egyptian.
Remember we had this conversation a while back where if you ever...
Oh, yeah!
Oedipus, he actually has to go against the sphinx. Also, if you guys ever... if anyone knows, I do love... Assassin's Creed Odyssey, they have a whole level where you have to go up against the Sphinx. And I think she's really cool, because the Sphinx gives you riddles.
I am trying to remember the Egyptian headpiece that the Sphinx usually has.
Because I know that's why I thought it was possibly Egyptian, because if I remembered correctly, that is what they call that big giant thing, and it is the Sphinx.
I think it's Egyptian in origin.
Yeah. But it also has Greek ties.
Yeah.
Though I think in the Egyptian one, it's a pharaoh. It's a male, not female. Unless they learn new things about it. The last I had heard, it's a male. Excuse me.
Don't count me. I don't know.
But in Greek mythology, from my understanding, it is female. But whenever I do anything mythological, I completely abort...
do not remember what the headpiece really looks like, so I'm guessing.
When I do anything with mythology, I just abort genders and make them my own. They can be any gender.
Well, yeah, but the headpiece isn't a gender thing.
No, it's not. I'm saying on the whole thing whether the Sphinx is male or female. Because if I'm correct, in Greek, it's female, but in, I don't know, I think from, like, that big statue thing they have in Egypt, that one's male, I think, the last I had heard.
I have no idea.
I don't either, but that's why I said I don't care about gender when it comes to those.
Oh, the Egyptian sphinxes, I think, don't have wings.
They don't, no. But this one is more off of the Greek one.
So right now I'm drawing the Greek.
Yes.
Version of a
Sphinx. The Greek version, because I really love Greece. I've been to Greece, man, and it is beautiful. I love it so much. I miss it. It's like heaven on earth. Oh, I love the face. You can still bring ties to the Egyptian, though.
Yeah, I did with the headpiece.
Yeah.
The whole thing just looks trash. I hate it.
It's interesting just to see what you decide to do. I love those claws, though.
I'm not the best at drawing animals. As you can see.
Right?
But I do love animals. Absolutely love drawing them, even though I freaking suck at it.
It just takes practice, so just remember, no matter how good of an artist you think you are, anything can be difficult.
Yeah, I'm actually gonna redo the legs.
But for those of you that struggle and are worried that your art isn't very good, it just takes practice, and everyone struggles.
Whoever decided that you don't need... Or whoever... Who was it that said that one of the worst things you can tell a starting artist is just to keep practicing? I think it was Lavender Tone.
Was it? I love Lavender Tone, but that is... I do have to agree with you on
that. Yeah, that's not a bad thing.
I know. Well, I think it also depends on the person and how often they've heard it and how much they are upset with themselves. But in my opinion, I always like the idea of you can always get farther and don't look at others' art. Look at your own.
Yeah.
And like, see how far you've come.
Don't compare yourself to other artists.
Yeah, just look at your own past art and see how far you've come. Granted, there's always going to be something you're like, man, that was great, why didn't I do that? And then you just are like, okay, I need to start implementing that more.
Yeah, one of my, actually, slipping back into the JoJo thing here, one of my favorite JoJo artists, I had this problem where a lot of people were messaging her saying, you know, like, hey, I'm kind of upset that I can't draw like you. And her response was that whenever she starts a drawing and it just doesn't look good to her, she just keeps going until it's done.
Mm-hmm.
She doesn't like quit it or anything. She just keeps going. And I think that's a good lesson to take. I've actually like done that myself, and I was actually quite surprised that it did actually help me.
Mm-hmm.
So I would say if you're one of those people who are like just really upset with your art, just try something like that. Just try to, like, keep drawing.
And if you can't keep doing it, don't be afraid to take a little 5-minute break, maybe an hour. Because I know myself, if I'm not happy with something, I take a little break. And then I come back to it and see, how can I solve this dilemma that I'm having? And that helps me. Everybody has their own experiences and their own way things that make it easier and harder for them, for themselves.
Yeah.
You need to just find your own way and your own path, basically.
Yeah.
Just takes time and effort. And sure power of will.
100% 50. I messed that up.
I don't know. What is that one from? I can't remember.
It's a Fort Minor song.
Oh, right. So many references in this.
Yeah.
I love the pose, though. That's a cool... Like, I know you said you're having trouble with it, but that is a really cool thing.
Yeah, this is a pose I would usually give for, like, a dragon.
I like it, though. It works. Like, you... Let me get a close-up of those little beanies. The little beanies!
I don't like this pose.
It's... Just keep going! It's turning out actually pretty cool. I don't know if I could actually get something that great.
You're not gonna be getting an animal type.
I know. I'm not getting an animal type?
No.
Oh, no.
Well, I guess it could be an animal type.
I don't know.
It depends on how you view it.
Yeah, it depends.
But the one I'm going to give you is not an animal type.
Hmm.
It will have some aspect of an animal on it, though.
Okay.
Is it the tail of a lion or just the tail of a cat?
It's the tail of a lion, because its lower body is a lion. Granted, if you want to go with the normal cat tail, I don't care.
No.
But,
This one is
the... Traditionally, it's got the body of a lion. Sometimes it's the upper torso, other times it's just the head of a woman. It just depends on what version you're going for. And wings.
Yeah, I'm just doing... Also, I've had, like, so much practice with wings, too.
Wings aren't actually that horrible. The hardest part I find for wings is getting the shape right.
For me, it's more just getting, like, the ultra details. So, like...
Yeah, it's annoying is what it gets to be after a while, because there's so many. That's why when I'm just doing sketches of them, I just scribble. Just scribble those wings in. Don't worry about the details. They'll make themselves known.
I personally like giving, like, little details, like
I like lines. That, too. I agree. I do that once I'm going really serious and I want to have a really serious drawing or finished-looking piece. But when I'm just having a sketch, I just sort of, you know.
Yeah.
Scribble time.
Anyway, there's my Sphinx.
Oh, man, that is so cool.
I hate it.
I love it.
The only part of this that I actually like is Echo.
I like the...
He looks sexy.
He does. Yeah, that's all of yours. Man, they all turned out really good. I'm so jealous.
And I can't wait to see what
I want to take Echo home.
You can totally take Echo
I'm
home.
I'm just going to cut those two, like, you keep them, and I'm taking Echo
Oh,
with
thanks.
Me.
I get to keep your junk art. Granted, I want this as a sticker.
No, I'm not.
I want a sticker version of it.
No, I'm not taking
it's so
two
cute.
Stickers.
Just make it a sticker for me. I want to put it on my little drawer set.
You better
set.
Pay me for it.
Okay.
Pay me $20.
Okay.
For one sticker.
Okay. I don't care. You're my friend. I'll buy you dinner. I'll buy you lunch one day. I mean, technically, I'll buy you lunch
today.
Yeah,
you bought me lunch today.
All right. Are we ready to go to me then?
Yeah.
All right. Let's do it. Last one.
All right. So, once again, we are back with the mythology. It's Amber's turn, as you can tell. Thankfully, the creature that I am giving her is quite lanky. So she doesn't have to worry about the elephant being in her way,
no.
Depending on the pose that she decides to give it. So, this creature is from Navajo mythology.
Ah!
So Native Americans.
That's cool. I don't know a lot of Navajo mythology.
This is actually a creature that is quite prominent in the entirety of Native American lore.
Okay.
However, it was first brought up or first explored in Navajo mythology.
Okay.
Don't quote me on that. I could be wrong.
Yeah, we are not, what is, historians? Is it historians who study mythology? I don't know who does it. We are not the people who know this stuff.
But this creature has the skull of a deer as its head.
Okay.
And its body is very skinny.
Okay.
It has lots of fur on its back and right to its chest. Its arms are very skinny.
Oh, is it a Wendigo?
Yes.
Sweet! Okay, I actually know this one.
Yes. Their arms are very skinny and bony, and their hands are typically really long claws.
Yeah.
And it has deer legs.
Okay.
And it's bipedal.
Okay. Yep, I remember that.
And usually a Wendigo who has feasted upon humans will have the human skulls adorned on their chest.
Oh, dang.
So
this is hard. I'm not good at, like, anything that deals with bones.
Yeah, this is why I said you'd hate me. So, go ahead and draw your Wendigo.
Okay, so you said deer skull head?
It has, it could be any animal, but
yeah,
it's usually
typically a deer, a buck skull.
Buck skull, yes.
Yeah, okay. So, let's see here. It's, what do I want to do for this pose?
Occasionally you will see in some Wendigo horror stories that their eyes will be glowing red. However, typically in the Native American stories, their eyes are hollow like an actual skull. So you can choose to either have a hollow skull.
Okay.
Or you can have some kind of glow.
Okay. You know, the few times I've actually, these antlers suck.
Make them pointier.
I'm going to. The couple times I've actually drawn skulls is during, like, oh, what is it? Oh, mermaid. And I have that one, I have that type of mermaid I like to make where it's, like, tribal. And so I've actually drawn it, I drew it twice now, actually, in the last 2 years, I think. And I even made myself, a version of, oh, yeah, I made that. So I did an Oscar mermaid, and so they gave it the skull and fish, and then I did that one where it had, where it was, an angler fish, and I, gave that one more of just, like, the bottom jaw of a, like, I gave that one also, like, an angler skulls, which I thought was really cool and different, because I don't really draw a lot of, like, skull or gory stuff. It's not my typical style.
Usually Wendigos will have sharp jagged teeth, but if it's a deer skull, you don't have to give it jagged teeth. At least give it fangs, though.
Well, yeah.
They gotta tear off human flesh somehow.
I don't know how the skull of a deer actually works, so I'm just taking random guesses here.
I actually did once draw a Wendigo with a bear skull.
Oh, yeah?
And that was messed up.
I really don't know anything about deer anatomy. Most of my deers end up looking like dogs. I actually have a sketch of one that looks like I ended up making a deer dog. Because it just looked like one. This could be good or it could just be terrible. So, yeah. I want to give it some
flesh. If you want.
No, this is like little flesh
bits. The whole body is furry, by the way.
Okay.
It's just there's a lot more fur around the back and neck.
Okay. I want to give it and then like some little cracking.
They don't usually have they don't usually have tails.
Okay.
But if you want to give it the tail of a deer, mm-hmm. depending on how the pose is going to work,
yeah,
that is also acceptable. I'm hardcore judging on this because...
That nose is horrible. I know that nose is bad.
Upside down heart.
Well, no, actually, if I remember, the nostrils are... Is this one just... I think it's just a nostril. I have no idea.
Either way, for the viewers at home, if you want to know kind of more on the Wendigo style, there is a game for the PlayStation 4 called Until Dawn. They are not the usual Wendigos, as those ones are more human-like. But it is a very, very good game. There are jump scares. There's jump scares. There's a lot of gore. So, just be in mind, be careful of that.
Nothing is sponsored, by the way,
not sponsored.
Yeah.
But it is a very good game. I would suggest, if you haven't played it, or if you're not able to play it, due to, like, the pricing of the game, or the fact that you don't have a PS4, I would suggest watching Markiplier or Jacksepticeye playing it. Once again, not sponsored, not affiliated. but those are two very excellent gamers, and they both did a really good job on that game. Mark actually had this really big blunder that made him restart the whole game, and it was great.
So I have no idea what's going on because you keep talking, so I don't know if I'm drawing this right or not.
I mean, you don't listen to me anyway, so it's not like you're gonna get big, big fuzz on its neck and back.
Okay. It's true though, I don't listen.
I also like big fuzz.
Is it like on its chest or what's is
yeah,
it chest hairy?
It goes down to its chest.
Okay. I just would have pictured more skeletals.
Well, sometimes they can be really skeletal if mm-hmm. they haven't eaten for a while. But the one I'm giving you is not fully skeletal.
Okay.
So it still has some beef
okay.
on it. So it's got kind of a slightly muscular chest.
Okay.
Yeah,
I don't draw muscular chests at all.
Yeah, it's mm-hmm. it's fuzzy, so okay. it's not like you really see anything. And it has the bottom half of a deer.
Okay.
So, no pelvis bones.
Dang, pelvis bones would have been cool.
Dang, how cool would it have been if Echo was, like, half Wendigo?
That would be cool.
Dang, look at them hips, though.
Right? Maybe, I don't know if this is like a... I don't know.
That's one sexy Wendigo.
I'm gonna give it some patches of, like, mange.
Okay.
I don't know what mange is. I just know it's a term. I'm gonna try.
Mange is a disease that eats away, like, fur.
Yeah. I wanna give...
You'll typically find it on dogs.
Yeah, but I still wanna try it.
Yeah.
Is it arms? What is its arms?
Arms are really skinny, bony.
Okay. Are they fluffy at all, or just bony?
Yeah, they're fluffy, but they're bony in structure.
Just so like all my arms in general.
So it's like you can kind of like see like the elbow jutting out and stuff.
Okay, kind of like how I already draw things because honestly I don't know how to add meat to my characters.
Yeah, and the hands are just unless really it's their hips. Claws.
Okay. This is already horrible. At least the head looks somewhat decent. I'm not gonna give it a total of 5. It's only getting 4. Cause I'm lazy.
Well, actually, this one does only have 4 fingers, so.
Okay!
That's a short arm.
It's like this. It's like going towards you, like, Oh. Rrr.
Looks like a zombie.
Yeah. Well, they basically are. A zombie, half-breed. Wendigo. There. That is, my Wendigo. I feel
there
like
it is.
Wait.
Just no, you don't have to give me the balls.
It's a dude. It's fine.
Wendigos don't have gender.
It does now.
Whatever. Anyway, do you want to see
drawing? Don't assume his gender.
Do you want to see the one I showed you?
Sure. Ah, oh, that's so cool.
Right?
Man, I wish I could draw cool things like that.
There we go. There's the whole thing. Woo.
Oh, it would sound more excited, why don't you? Yeah! So, that was fun. What do you think of it?
It was a hard one, that's for sure.
It was an experience.
Yeah, that's all I got. I definitely had fun, honestly. I'm gonna say drawing Echo was my favorite because that's my baby. I love him so much.
I honestly am surprised to say, but I really liked that Wendigo. That Wendigo turned out better than I could have thought. But I think we have to agree the worst part was when you tried drawing animals.
Yeah. I had hoped for the hard one, I had really hoped that she would give me, like, a dragon or a pegasus or something. Because I do like drawing dragons. Those are actually one of the things that I do draw a lot. And I also really like drawing horses. So,
with the animals, I'm just gonna say I draw much better than that elephant. If you've seen anything else, I can draw animals. That elephant just was not happening today.
Okay. Camera's on a time limit, okay?
Okay. So, anything you want to say, like shout outs or anything that you have for your like things you got, you know, like.
So if you want to follow me, you can follow me. On Twitter and Instagram at ellispades. It's at ellispades.
The link will be in the description, by the way.
Yeah.
Give him a follow. He has some really cool stuff.
Yeah. I do a lot of JoJo's Bizarre Adventure art. Some of it is not safe for work, so please be cautious when looking through my Twitter.
Basically, be 18 and up if you're going over there.
Looking through my Twitter. My Instagram is kind of, it's okay.
And as always, you can find me on Facebook, Tumblr, Twitter, and Ko-fi. Yeah, I mean, nothing else to say on that. Everything mentioned in this video, there will be a link in the description below for you to get to whatever you want. So, have a good weekend, you know, and stay safe and wear your mask.
Happy Thanksgiving.
Granted, this will be coming out the day after Thanksgiving.
But happy Thanksgiving anyway.
Hope it was good for you. Bye-bye.